English Talk Time is about 4 years old now at the Thomas Crane Public Library, designed to help folks strengthen their English skills. And Molly Makrogianis is the director. Molly, welcome.
Thank you. Happy to be here.
Yeah, it's nice to learn about this program. First I'd heard of it, actually, so I'm guessing other folks are in that same boat. Tell me a little bit about English Talk Time.
The program is a series of English conversation groups that are held at the library. And like you said, they are for people who are international members of the Quincy community who are looking to improve their English, have an opportunity to socialize, and really just get out and start getting more involved in the community.
Yeah, what are the discussions about? What do they talk about at English Talk Time?
Well, typically the conversations relate to language that's practical for our participants. So we focus on things like going to the grocery store or maybe a visit to the DMV or things that are just helpful for them in making them feel more confident in their everyday interactions in English.
Okay. And about, you know, how long would somebody participate in a Talk Time program?
Some of our students have been in the program really for the 4 years that it's been in existence.
Yeah.
Some people just depend on whether they move or things like that. It may be shorter term. But each conversation group runs for 10 weeks. So someone would be with us for at least the 10 weeks. And then most often they're interested in continuing on for an additional program. So
okay.
They'll come back for another 10 weeks and so on.
Now, really, the heart of the program is the volunteers that kind of conduct the discussions.
Talk
to us about the volunteers and who they are and how you become one.
We're really fortunate that, like you said, it's really like the heart and soul of the program are the volunteers who serve as facilitators for the conversation groups. So what's nice about the program is that it is just conversation-based. So volunteers don't need to have any experience teaching English. You don't have to get into any grammar or anything technical with the students. Our students, we make sure that they already have a basic level of English, so they're able to participate in the conversation. And our facilitators really just help sort of guide them through that interaction. The group meets for about an hour and a half.
Okay.
So we look for people who are really just curious about meeting people from around the world, who are interested in helping newly arrived people sort of acclimate to the Quincy community,
mm-hmm.
And help them better their English in order to get more involved in not only the library but also their jobs and areas all around.
Do the volunteers need to be trained beforehand?
We do have a training. A conversation group will run for 10 weeks.
Yeah.
So our training program actually follows one conversation group.
Okay.
So in the beginning, I'll be there with the new volunteers, and I'll probably primarily lead the first session, and the volunteers sort of observe and participate on a limited basis. And as the 10 weeks go on, the volunteers get more and more involved in the leading, so that the idea is by the end of the 10 weeks, they feel confident in how to choose a topic, prepare a lesson, and facilitate the group.
Right. I was wondering, how do they choose what to talk about? An hour and a half is a long time. You know, do I talk all about one topic, how to catch a bus, or do I, you know, talk about how to grocery shopping, or what I do for Christmas?
Sure. And typically, I think it starts with just as everyone gets more comfortable and to know each other, some really just nice natural conversation often forms. So part of the group, I think, is spent just in that, catching up and giving people an opportunity to talk about what's happening in their lives.
Where are you from? What do you do?
Yeah.
What do you like? Okay.
Yeah, and then we do try to structure part of the time so that it really is something useful where, like we said, people feel more confident when they actually go to a job interview and maybe some questions they'll encounter. So in the training, we do talk about it's mostly with the input of the students, how to choose the topics, and then how to just, in a simplified manner, just bring something structured so that you have some talking points and sort of a general lesson plan to follow.
Right. So the volunteer really doesn't need to know the native language of the students.
No, definitely not.
We're
really fortunate that we have a nice, diverse group of students from all over. So typically you'll have five or six different languages represented in a group. So we certainly wouldn't look for people who spoke all of those languages.
Right, exactly. That would be almost impossible, actually.
Right.
Obviously, here in Quincy and on the South Shore, a strong Asian population, so you probably see a lot of Asian folks mm-hmm. coming to look to strengthen their English skills.
We do. We have a decent amount of Asian students in our program, mainly from China and Vietnam, I'd say. We also have quite a few students from Northern Africa, like Morocco and Egypt, We also have some Portuguese speakers from Brazil, and then sort of just a smattering of people from other other areas.
Is there a cost at all, Molly, for the program, either for the students or for the volunteers?
No, this is a free program offered by the library to the students, and there's no cost for the volunteers either.
Very good. How would folks get more information about it?
Well, if you go to the thomascrane.org website, there is a drop-down menu at the top. And if you select English Talk Time from that drop-down menu, it'll take you to our website.
Very good. Or telephone 617-376-3295.
That's correct.
All right. Thank you so much for stopping by to tell us more about this. It's really interesting, and it's a great value, really, for the community and for the folks who are newly arrived, especially, I'm sure.
Thank you. We think so, too, and we get wonderful feedback from both our students and volunteers as to just how sort of dynamic and enriching the program really is.
Thanks again.
Thank you.
You're welcome.